welcome. So welcome to Folsom Lake College's 10th anniversary celebration. Yeah. So I saw several of you dancing to the music. There's going to be more options and possibilities for you to dance again during this presentation. So this is all about celebration, and it's about celebrating the founders of this wonderful college. But before I start into our program, another big round of applause for the Afro-Cuban Funk Band and Urban Jazz Project. So as I said, today we are here to celebrate the college's 10th anniversary because it received its initial accreditation in 2004. And many of you here had a hand in that momentous achievement. So we're here to celebrate this wonderful college, the synergy of Folsom, El Dorado, and Rancho Cordova, acknowledge the tremendous commitment it took by so many of you to take a vision and turn it into a reality. And what a reality, right? We've got something really special here. We're gonna do a pictorial journey down memory lane, so I'll tell you the story of Folsom through pictures, hear from some of our founding leaders, and be entertained by the Mosaic Dance Company. So lots and lots to share with you, and we're gonna end today with the introduction of the newest member of the Folsom Lake College family. So with that, it is now my pleasure, I'm going to introduce my boss, the Chancellor of the Los Rios Community College District, Dr. Brian King.
One of the real successes of the Los Rios District has been the wonderful service of these elected board members. So let's give a hand to Robert and Pam on behalf of all of the board members. And I know there will be numerous opportunities to acknowledge the pioneers, but would everyone wear a button, stand up so we can see where you are and give you a big round of applause, all of our pioneers? This has the feel of a party in so many different ways, and one of them, it has the feel of a reunion. I see people who maybe haven't seen each other for a while exchanging hugs and getting caught up in what's going on now. In the Los Rios District, I have learned a different meaning of retirement. I want to acknowledge two supposedly retired pioneers who are here with us today. First is Bryce Harris, who is Chancellor of the District, and was such a key person in having the foresight and vision to develop a plan to educate a region in collaboration with the board. And his idea of retirement is serving as chancellor of our statewide community college system. So let's thank Bryce for his service, both at Folsom Lake and Los Rios and across the state. I'm not going to use finger quotes, but I would use it again in introducing another supposedly retired pioneer, and that's Thelma Scott Skillman, the first president at FLC. Thelma's idea of retirement is interesting as well. Most of you know that she served as interim chancellor at the City College of San Francisco, and I think that term is measured in dog years, Thelma. And when that ended, you would think that she would relax, but she currently is serving as interim executive director of the Community College League of California. So that's Thelma Scott Skillman in retirement. When you walk around this campus, when you see this campus, you see Thelma's fingerprints everywhere, and this is definitely a great legacy for Thelma. Her attention to detail and her passion for FLC is so obvious. In so many ways, Thelma has loved and nurtured FLC the way a good parent loves and nurtures their children. And I know she couldn't be any prouder to be here today to celebrate Folsom Lake College on its 10th birthday. So thank you, Thelma Scott Skillman. Now, the idea of a birthday party, when I think about a 10th birthday party, it makes me think a little bit about my own kids. Any of you have a 10-year-old at home now? Some of you have a 10-year-old under your roof. My kids are teenagers now. They're not too far removed from being 10, but you know, when the years go by, you stop and think, what is a 10-year-old like? So I went to the most basic tool of good parenting. You know what I'm talking about? Google. And here is some information about what to expect from a 10-year-old at a 10-year-old birthday party. Now, the first one I don't think applies. It says that 10-year-olds have great ideas and intentions, but difficulty following through. So that one I marked out right away. That's not true. The others, I thought, had a lot to say about this college in its 10th year. Is eager to learn and master new skills. That certainly has been true and one of the hallmarks of Folsom Lake College. Is proud of doing things well. You walk around this campus, you look in the classrooms, the pride of this organization is so obvious. Enjoys planning and organizing tasks. You can't start a new college, you can't achieve accreditation without doing a great job of planning and organizing tasks. And the last one I thought was a good one to wrap up with, fantasizes and daydreams about the future, because that is part of this celebration today as well. The first 10 years have been incredible, but these traits are a good description of Folsom Lake College as we look forward to the future. All of you should be justifiably proud of your first 10 years and excited about the great future in store for Folsom Lake College. So happy birthday, Folsom Lake College, on your 10th anniversary and 10th birthday. And now it is my privilege to introduce the current chair of the governing board of the Los Rios Community College District, Robert Jones.
Thank you, Chancellor King. And good afternoon, everyone. It's my great privilege to bring you greetings from your governing board. We levitate up in the stratosphere fairly high and try to stay out of your way as you do wonderful things. We do try to originate policy and authorize budgets and do things that help you get the results that are so spectacularly evident here at Folsom Lake. The board wanted me to share with you their enthusiasm and excitement for this occasion, and also to recognize the accomplishments of the past and to acknowledge the very bright future ahead. We shouldn't forget, incidentally, the significant and continuing investment that the people of the Capital Region, the Sacramento area and beyond, have made in supporting the district's colleges and centers and continue to provide the very best, we continue to provide the very best in post-secondary education and related community services. We are living up to the public's expectation and doing so in ways that are fully evident when you wander around this campus and have the privilege of going to some classrooms. I think we have more than fulfilled our obligation to provide the Capital Region with the kind of educational assets that they expected when they passed two very, very large bonds some number of years ago. Well, today we're celebrating achievements and our accumulated achievements and the people who made them possible. We acknowledge the many individuals and institutions that came before us who had the remarkable foresight to clearly understand the challenges and probable needs of the future, and we have those people with us today. That future was envisioned when the hills upon which the campus now stands served as a seasonal home for range cattle and other wild critters. Now it's the permanent home of thousands of FLC falcons who will, over the decades ahead, participate in shaping the Capital Region's destiny. Today, we honor the past and anticipate the future, a very bright future indeed for the campus and for the district as a whole. Again, on behalf of the members of your governing board, we thank you for all that you do and all that you've done in the past, and know that the lives of our students and the people of the Capital Region will be enriched for decades ahead as a result. Thank you very much. And now it's my great privilege to introduce to you the mayor of the city of Folsom, Carrie Harrell. Carrie?
I've been in Folsom for a really long time, and I hate to have to correct Board Member Jones, but those of you who live and work and play in Folsom know that this is really, it's not the Capital Region, it's the Folsom metropolitan area. So, sorry for that correction. No, I've been here a long time, and I remember when the cattle were grazing up here long before any of these beautiful buildings were here, and before this building in particular. I was here on that very, very hot day when we did the groundbreaking. I think it was like 140 degrees that day. But I'm thrilled to be here. I spent most of last weekend in this very room, Friday night at the Roseanne Cash concert, and then Sunday at the Community Concert Association to see that wonderful Jerry Sager perform. It was awesome. And I post about this stuff on Facebook, and all of my friends keep saying, wow, you people have all that great stuff going on in Folsom? It's like, yeah, you might want to come visit. So anyway, I'm happy to be representing the city here today with a resolution of commendation for the 10th anniversary or the 10th birthday of the college, and I'd like to read it for you. This is a resolution of commendation honoring Folsom Lake College's 10th anniversary. Whereas Folsom Lake College is celebrating its 10th anniversary since receiving its initial accreditation in 2004, and Folsom Lake College was originally a part of the Consumnes River College system, and in 1992 was accepted as the fourth college of the Los Rios Community College District. And whereas Los Rios Community College District is one of the nation's most respected learning institutions and the second largest community college district in California, with more than 77,000 students, and Folsom Lake College quickly emerged as a growing, vibrant, and dynamic educational institution in the community, and today includes the El Dorado Center in Placerville and the Rancho Cordova Center in Sacramento. And whereas due to tremendous growth of the Folsom region, see, I told you, it's the Folsom region, Folsom Lake College's facilities quickly expanded and currently include over 200,000 square feet of state-of-the-art instructional space, an enormous library and computer lab, physical education and athletics facilities and fields, and the renowned Harris Center for the Arts. And whereas the mission of Folsom Lake College is to serve the diverse communities of eastern Sacramento and western El Dorado counties, cultivating in its students the ability to think critically and to communicate purposefully and persuasively so that they may be engaged and informed global citizens. And whereas Folsom Lake College's vision is to inspire excellence and provide educational opportunities to enrich and empower students, and now, therefore, I, Carrie Howell, Mayor of the City of Folsom, on behalf of the Folsom City Council, the Folsom community, and the entire Folsom metropolitan area, it doesn't say that in here, I just added it, do hereby extend commendations in the highest regard to Folsom Lake College as they celebrate their 10th anniversary. Passed and approved this 10th day of October, 2014.
And I do want to share with you that Carrie is a longtime supporter of Folsom Lake College and is a founding member of the Folsom Lake College Foundation. So, thank you. So, thank you to Brian, to Robert, and to Carrie. And next on our program, I'd like you to please welcome Mosaic Dance Company.
Like everybody. Like ships in the night, you keep passing me by. We're just wasting time, trying to prove who's right. And if it all goes crashing into the sea, if it's just you and me trying to find a light. Like ships in the night, letting cannonballs fly. Say what you mean and it turns to a fight. Fists fly from my mouth as it turns south. You're down the driveway, I'm on the couch. Chasing your dreams since the violent fifth grade. Trying to believe in your silent own way. Cause we'll be okay, I'm not going away. Like you watched it 14 as we went down the drain. And pop stayed the same and your mom smoothed away. How many of our parents seem to make it anyway? We're just fumbling through the gray. Trying to find a heart that's not walking away. Turn the lights down. In the night, you keep passing me by. We're just wasting time, trying to prove who's right. And if it all goes crashing into the sea, if it's just you and me trying to find a light. Like ships in the night, you're passing me by, you're passing me by. Second plane had to pack and you cramps and I was late. Headed to a red carpet, they won't know my name. Riding in silence, all that we wanna say. About to board when you call on the phone. You say I'm sorry, I'll be waiting at home. Feels like we're burning this out on our own. Trying to find a way down a road we don't know.
Turn the lights down.
In the night, you keep passing me by. We're just wasting time, trying to prove who's right. And if it all goes crashing into the sea, if it's just you and me trying to find a light. Like ships in the night, you're passing me by, you're passing me by.
So hard in the paint, they can't wait for some more. But some others say we preachy. Some closed-minded geeches. Like we ain't heard of Marx like a Nietzsche. Believe me.
Like they don't know about us. They don't know about us. Like they don't know about us. They don't know about us. Like they don't know about us. They don't. They think we dumb, dumb, diddy, dumb, dumb.
But they gon' know. They gon' know about us. They gon' know about us. Hey, they gon' know about us. They gon' know about us. Oh, they gon' know about us. They gon' know about us. Oh, they gon' know about us. They gon'
know about us.
They say we finna go.
Dumb on them like I could be. Dumb on them like you should be. Dumb on them like I would be. Dumb on them, yeah, that's cool with me.
Like they don't know about us, they don't know about us. Like they don't know about us, they don't know about us. Like they don't know about us, they don't. They think we dumb, dumb, diddy, dumb, dumb.
But they gon' know about us. They gon' know about us. Hey, they gon' know about us. They gon' know about us. Oh, they gon' know about us. They gon' know about us. Oh, they gon' know about us. They gon' know about us.
Diddy dum, dum, 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 diddy dum, dum
from Mosaic Dance Company. And you should know that those students are part of a student club. So they choreograph those pieces themselves, and they're under the direction of the faculty advisor, Professor Debbie Wirth. So nicely done. I'm waiting for the next, there we go, it's me. All right, so the next part of our program, we're gonna take you through a pictorial journey of the history of Folsom Lake College. And to do that, we're gonna ask three founding members of the Folsom Lake College to do that. I've only been here 2 short years, and I thought you would appreciate hearing from founders. And so, but before they come up and join me, I just wanted to set the stage. So long before Folsom Lake College stood on its own, which we do now, it was part of 2 sister colleges, and you've heard that alluded to already today. And first, do you know who we are a part of? American River College, right? So then we became part of? CRC, Cosumnes River College. But finally, right, in 2004, we became Folsom Lake College, all right? We may only be 10 years old as Folsom Lake College, but the history actually dates back almost 50 years, and that's attributed to our El Dorado Center. All right. So, but now I want you to think back, not 50 years, but 25 years ago. How many of you folks were here 25 years ago, at least in this area? So many of you, yeah? All right, so think back 25 years. So 1989, 1990, you remember this? That, my friends, is Bidwell, right? This lonely sign standing by the railroad tracks pointing as if to nowhere, right? But it wasn't pointing to nowhere because we were teaching classes in the portables up behind that hill and along the winding road in El Dorado Center towards Placerville, and we were teaching students all across the city of Rancho Cordova. Skip and I were talking about that in the lobby. Right? Anywhere we could find a place to put a class, we would do so. So we were alive and well there. It just wasn't hard to, it was hard to tell. And look at us today, okay? So I'm gonna ask the three individuals who are gonna join me up here in a moment, and I've asked Rochelle Franco, Dave Hill, and Kim Harrell to tell you the story of Folsom Lake College. Rochelle's gonna tell you about the earliest days at the El Dorado Center. Dave's gonna talk about the Folsom Lake College, Maine, before it was Maine. And then Kim is gonna share the college's progress over the last decade. So with that, I turn the program over to Rochelle. Please welcome Rochelle Franco.
Well, good afternoon. So as Rachel mentioned, our Folsom Lake College's history actually dates back to 1966, when the then Placerville Center began offering classes at the National Guard Armory on the El Dorado County Fairgrounds. And if you look really close, you can see Placerville Center. At that time, the center was operated by American River College and served approximately 200 students. As you can see, Placerville Center students were not only intelligent, but they were strong. And if you've ever walked up Ray Lawyer Drive from Rayleigh's, this is what it actually feels like. And no, that is not Jim Carrey. In 1977, the center moved to a new location above the fairgrounds, known affectionately in the community as UBR, or the University Behind Rayleigh's. The Placerville Center remained under the auspices of American River College until 1985, when Cosumnes River College took over operations. The Los Rios Board of Trustees authorized the purchase of approximately 19 acres of land from the El Dorado County Board of Education for $1. The location was approved by the State Chancellor's Office and the State of California for a permanent site in 1988. And this is a photo taken at the EDC groundbreaking ceremony. And here is a picture of faculty and staff taking a tour of Building B at the El Dorado Center. And I'm sure the hard hats were passed out inside the building. The Placerville Center officially opened in fall of 1994, so this semester marks 20 years since that opened, at which time its name was changed to the El Dorado Center. EDC could best be described as the community's college, a place the residents of El Dorado County could come to pursue a degree or certificate, acquire or update job skills, or take classes to pursue a new interest. EDC has always had a strong support system in the community. From the El Dorado County Office of Education, to the local newspaper, the Mountain Democrat, and to its patrons club, who meet monthly, hold an annual luncheon to raise money for scholarships, and assist at graduation. EDC is a gold nugget in the mother lode. I'd like to take a moment to tell you about the impact UBR-EDC had on a student. The student graduated from El Dorado High School and took college prep classes, but the thought of stepping on the campus of Sac State terrified her. She went to UBR, met with a counselor, and got enrolled in her first semester of classes. A few semesters later, she enrolled in student government and served as a student representative. Her involvement with student government, working in several departments on campus, along with the support and encouragement of faculty and staff, helped to build her confidence, and eventually she became part of EDC's first graduating class in 1995. EDC treated that student so well that she decided to stick around and make a career of giving back to students and the college, and that student stands before you today. And I'm just one example of how UBR-EDC transforms the lives of its students. So to the administrators, faculty, and staff of UBR-EDC, I say thank you and know that you're making a difference in the lives of our students, the community, and even your colleagues. And now to continue with the history of Folsom Lake College is Dave Hill.
I couldn't help but notice when the founding fathers or mothers of this campus stood up, there was a glow that came from all the gray hair that reflects off the lighting. You can tell we've been around a while, and we are so happy to celebrate with all of you the 10th anniversary. Well, while they were having their exciting times at El Dorado Center, we were having our own fun here at Folsom. It's my opportunity to recap the history of Folsom Lake College during the decade of the 1990s. Those were the cowboy days in the history of Folsom Lake, as Skip can attest to. That's what we did, and then asked permission, and then not always asked permission. We got things done. As many of you know, the Folsom Lake College story actually began at Mather Air Force Base, where we were the Mather Outreach Center of Cosumnes River College, as you saw. Then we moved to the strip mall here in Folsom, to the DMV, near the DMV, where we really got, where established a storefront, and our operations began in earnest. We operated that for over a year until the ground was broken in 1992, and the trailers were brought in from El Dorado Center and set in place just east of us here on the 151 acres that had been sitting vacant for all those years. We opened our fledgling campus on the spring semester of 1993 on a chilly, wet January day. This was the day before, on Monday, Martin Luther King Day. You could probably see Skip there with a screed board in the background. We were so desperate to get our sidewalks in so that on the next day we were able to invite our students, and they came. That's the day, our first day opening in Folsom Lake College. It was an ocean nightmare, but our students had access to the classrooms and the portables. Our students in those days were so patient, and we'll hear about one more thing they were patient with in a minute. We started our first semester with 900 students, which made us smaller than any of our surrounding high schools. We tried to make it look as inviting as we could, and this is the best we could do. Even though we are an outreach center of Cosumnes River College, you'll notice what we capitalized in our sign. That was not a mistake. We thought over that quite carefully. And we did it for this reason. That's the way we felt in those days. We consider ourselves the future Folsom Lake College. They were the exciting years. We did whatever it took to build our student population and to establish a legitimate institution of higher learning. All those who worked here in those days knew each other, and we all worked hard for the same cause. It was hard to tell faculty from staff and from administration. We all did whatever it took to build a new college. With our limited space, we are indeed a one-stop shop in all senses of the word. You are looking at the administration building, the counseling center, and EOPNS, and financial aid, and everything wrapped up into one. That was our first administrative building there on campus. We taught our classes, though we are a one-stop shop for the student services, we taught our classes in over 17 locations in the Folsom-Cordova area, including Franchise Tax Board, Intel, Hewlett-Packard, Folsom Prison, both inside and out. Rancho Cordova storefronts, local churches, local schools, including Folsom and Mills Middle Schools, Folsom, Oak Ridge, and Cordova High Schools. We taught at various daycare centers, including KinderCare and La Petite, Folsom Chamber of Commerce, local gyms, including Gold's and Mueller Fitness, Lake Bowl, Notomas Aqua Center, and I better stop there, but the list goes on. Each of you who sit in this room who's taught in those facilities has a fondness for those locations, I'm sure. One of the many challenges we faced in those cowboy days was having rattlesnakes trying to attend our classes with our students. These little critters would slither their way onto the campus on nearly a daily basis. At first, it was my job to capture and relocate the snakes. I should have read the fine print in my contract at the time, but again, we did whatever it took. Security then took over the task, and finally we hired professional help. I think I can safely say that we were probably the only college in the state to designate money in our budget to hire a professional snaker. Recruiting students was a big task at that time. We tried to make our small campus look bigger. Future students would find their way to our portables, come to the reception counter and say, "I came for a tour of your college. Where is it?" And we would proudly display on all of our brochures this fine photograph of our large campus. Well, we did get bigger, and we grew out to this footprint. This takes us to the end of the decade. And we built additional buildings, the Child Care Center, and our Learning Resource Center. And then in 1999, after the collaborative efforts of skilled architects and knowledgeable educators, the time arrived for the construction of our first permanent structure. We had a groundbreaking ceremony and construction went into high gear. You'll notice some of the people you recognize as our visiting dignitaries and past Folsom Lake founders in these following pictures. There's the skipper. Undoubtedly, his turquoise Bronco is out in the parking lot somewhere. And you can see some of the others as we had that groundbreaking for our buildings that we now have on our campus. Kim will tell you of the wonderful things that happened on our campus since then, but before I turn it over to Kim, I'd like to share one last anecdote from this slide. During those pioneer days, I would often take my sack lunch and climb the hill to the very spot where the admissions and records building now stands. This photo was taken during one of those lunch breaks. I would sit there eating my lunch, and while looking over the barren landscape, would see in my mind's eye the college that would one day stand on this site. This auditorium in which we sit this morning and the other beautiful buildings and grounds that exist today are the fulfillment of the hopes and dreams that all of us had in those exciting years of Folsom Lake College's history. I will now turn the presentation over to Kim Harrell, who will share with you the progress of Folsom Lake College as it entered the 21st century.
Good afternoon. My leg of the story begins with the opening of FL1 in 2001, which marked the first real physical evidence of the community's college emerging on top of the hill. People would drive by on East Bidwell and Highway 15 and look up and say, "What is that building up there?" Well, as Dave mentioned, that building happened to be our one-stop shop of a college, where a student could do just about everything except take a science lab class, buy a book, or get something to eat. These were still functions of our portables, and if you remember, our microwave kiosks that we set up for students to warm up food during the day. Now, all of this construction was not without its challenges. It was a little unsettling to some of the local residents, including this rattlesnake, as Dave mentioned, and things did get a little heated at times. But through it all, we not only managed to expand our physical footprint, but in 2004, we achieved initial accreditation to become California's 109th community college. But we were just getting started. In 2005, we opened FL2, or Cypress Hall. And in 2006, we had the grand opening of our bookstore cafeteria, which was supposed to be named the Falcon's Nest. But thanks to some research done by our students who found that falcons don't nest, they do indeed roost, it became known as the Falcon's Roost. So we have our students to thank for that. In 2007, we welcomed Lilac and Dogwood Halls, so named through a participatory governance process led by our facilities naming subcommittee, who invited all our campus constituents to vote on a list of names of indigenous trees and plants, and this was the winning combination. In 2009, I don't think anyone was happier than the student services staff and faculty, except of course the PE faculty, when we opened our permanent physical education building. And that's because our old physical education building was the old community room, if you remember. And the wall to that room was directly adjacent to student services. So they didn't have to listen to, come on, and the yells of stomping feet on steps anymore in the building right next to them. And then in 2011, the crown jewel of the college, this Harris Center for the Arts, held its grand opening gala featuring a chorus line. And as if that weren't enough, then we decided to turn our attention to our outdoor facilities and expansion and improvement of our athletics fields and construction of a new gymnasium. And in 2013, this beautiful soccer field became the home of our championship women's soccer team and is now the home of our men's inaugural soccer team. And there's two soccer games today, by the way, 3:30 and 6 o'clock, so make sure you come by and see. And I don't think anyone was sad to see the last of the portables go in late 2013 to make room for the new gymnasium. If you ever were in the portables, you will be happy when you're out of there because you don't get skunked anymore, the roof doesn't leak on your desk when it rains, and you don't see ants carry your papers across your desk when it rains. So as we said goodbye to the last physical remnants of our old campus, we welcomed the construction of this amazing new gymnasium. And if you look here, let's see right here, you can see that from the top it's shaped like a falcon. Here's the beak and the tail and the two wings. Yeah, pretty cool. There's another view. So having served as an adjunct faculty member at UBR and a founding faculty member of Folsom Lake College, and now as a dean of workforce development, kinesiology, health, and athletics, I can't think of a better place to have grown over the last 20 years with some amazing colleagues, and I look forward to lots of great things to come. So with that, I will turn the presentation back over to our college president, Dr. Rachel Rosenfeld.
So a thank you to Rochelle and Dave and Kim. It's so terrific to hear from the folks who were here during the development of this beautiful college. And so what you just heard from them was what I call the Cliff Notes version of Folsom Lake College. But keep in mind, before their stories, Folsom's main claim to fame was rodeo, right? Folsom Rodeo. And what's the other one? The prison, right? Johnny Cash's tribute to Folsom Prison. And in fact, I was in Australia a couple of years ago on a vacation, had on my Folsom gear, of course, walk into a store, and the guy goes, Folsom, California! Said, yeah, from the song, he knew Folsom. So he did. But when you leave here today, I want you to remember one name, and that name is Jack Kipp. And some of you may have actually known Jack. Anybody know Jack? Oh, several of you. Okay. Jack was Folsom's mayor in the 1960s, and he was the visionary that saw a college in the future of Folsom. He's also the man who convinced the developers of Lexington Hills, which is the housing development just north of here, to donate the 151 acres that the main campus now sits on, the very site we are sitting on today. So he made this college possible. And so just a trivia, and we'll do this on a scavenger hunt at some point. There is a tribute to Jack Kipp. If you go out the north side of the Harris Center, there is a large rock with a plaque with his name on it, and that is acknowledging his contributions to Folsom Lake College. So, all right. So this college, we are now celebrating our 10th anniversary, 10 years of student success. So on behalf of the over 68,000 students who have passed through these doors just in the last 10 years, we want to say thank you to all the founders.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Just a huge thank you. I mean, if it weren't for this campus, I'd be going somewhere else, having to spend more money. I do pay my own way through school, so second year, zero debt is a great feeling to have.
Thank you.
Thank you for everyone who's helped make this campus possible. I plan on going to Sac State, and I'll be studying biology in the fall.
Thank you.
Okay. Yeah. So now I'd like to, our next part of the program is we're going to hear from three leaders from our college and district. And these are individuals who were here at the very beginning, whose contributions and commitment to turning a vision into the reality that we are enjoying today. And they are the ones who led those efforts and guided us through the building of Folsom Lake College. And we're going to begin with Bryce Harris, Chancellor of the California Community College System and Chancellor Emeritus of the Los Rios Community College District. Welcome.
Thank you, Rachel, and thanks very much for allowing me a little time on this really wonderful celebration today. I have often said that Folsom Lake College was, on the one hand, the slowest college ever developed in America, and on the other hand, the fastest, because as you saw in some of those photos, and especially the last one featuring former city leader Kipp, the property was deeded to the district back in the 70s, and in fact, when I came here in 1996 to interview for this job, they drove me by and ultimately to the temporary buildings at the time. But up on this hill, about where this center sits now, was a very old and faded 4x8 sign that said Future Home of Folsom Lake College, which I was told had been sitting on that site for nearly 20 years at the time. And so I do have to thank Mayor Howell and the members of the council and, frankly, this community for the patience they showed in driving by year after year a faded, increasingly sign that announced the future home of a college that probably at some point nobody ever thought was going to get built. And then they put those temporary buildings on, and I can recall during my interview process for the chancellor job in 1996, they brought me to the campus, and I had the opportunity for the first time to meet Skip Davies, then the campus dean, I think he was called, and I can still recall walking in his office and meeting him, and there on his desk was a jar full of formaldehyde with one of the rattlesnakes pickled inside. Now, I immediately, being from Western Oklahoma, found myself with a tremendous bond with Skip Davies. It was only later that we had conversations about the snake prevention efforts, and I walked the campus one day, and in fact, you could see it in one of those early photographs, a fence that was slanted, and I said to Skip, what happened to the fence? He said, oh, no, it's put in like that on purpose. I said, what do you mean? He said, that's a snake fence. And I said, what's a snake fence? He said, I said, at an angle, because those snakes, if they crawl up and then try to crawl up that fence, they'll fall back down on the ground. And I said, well, how deep in the ground is that snake fence set? And he said, oh, 3-6 inches. I hate to tell him, but in Western Oklahoma, snakes will burrow under the ground at least a foot or two. Never bothered to tell him that the snakes that he was preventing on the surface were probably just going right under the fence on the ground. But again, that snaker put that fence up, built the district, and caught a few snakes along the way. That was my my introduction to Skip. I have to also say that when Skip and I, working together, identified at the time Thelma Scott Skillman and talked her into coming to this campus, probably the luckiest day of our lives, because at the time the district hired the future president of this college and founding president, and when she ultimately took this job over, as you heard earlier, she used a tender, loving hand to build one of the finest institutions in the country. I can recall so many opportunities in that fast part of the development of this college. Once we passed the bond issues and the construction was started, I don't think there's another college in the country that has been built as quickly as has this one. I can recall numerous opportunities for Thelma and Skip and I in hard hats as we broke ground for building after building. I would be dishonest if I didn't tell you that Thelma always looked like, in those hard hats, she'd walked out of Vogue magazine, and Skip and I looked like a couple of construction guys they'd stuck in a suit to put a shovel in our hand. It was an exciting time, and you heard Dave refer to the sort of cowboy period of the institution. I will tell you that constructing these facilities, one right after another, due again to the generosity of the taxpayers of the state of California, and especially to the taxpayers of the Los Rios District, was a remarkable undertaking. I also have to pause to thank the elected Board of Trustees. You heard them acknowledged earlier. There are two of them with us today, Trustee Jones and Trustee Haynes. The stability of the Board of Trustees during the period of time of development of this campus was remarkable. And not only putting the two successful bond issues on the ballot, but the two unsuccessful ones that failed before we finally passed the first one, the Board stayed with us time after time, decision after decision, and now you see the fruits of their work. And so to the elected officials in the city of Folsom and to those in the Los Rios District, we owe a tremendous debt of gratitude for their patience and their persistence and their perseverance that have brought this campus to be what it is today. I'd also be remiss if I didn't acknowledge and thank a trustee who's no longer with us, the trustee from this region, Terry Cochran, who we lost a year or so ago. Terry was a ever-present cheerleader and advocate on the part of the community of Folsom, and certainly on behalf of this college. And so I'm not unlike Brian King in that I now have under my, purview, 112 colleges in this state. And although, like Brian, between college number two and college number 112, I don't get to have any favorites. But I'm more than happy to look anybody in the eye and tell them I do have one favorite college in California, and that's Folsom Lake College. Thank you all very much.
So thank you, Bryce. Next, I'd like to welcome to the podium a very special individual. This is Folsom Lake College's founding president. And when the college received its initial accreditation in 2004, she was at the helm. So please welcome Dr. Thelma Scott Skillman.
Happy birthday, Folsom. It is such a pleasure and an honor to be here celebrating the 10 years for Folsom Lake College. I always knew this day would come because we invested so much money and time and effort in picking the right people to serve as the founding faculty, staff, and administrators for this institution. And I knew then, many, many years ago, that this institution was going to become known as the destination point for this region. When I first came out here, there was a recognition that this area had a prison, and many of us talked long and hard about making sure that we would change that. And I know today, when we talk to others about what's in Folsom, it's about Folsom Lake College. It's about this institution and all the wonderful people and the programs and services that are here and the dedication of making sure that all of the individuals that come through the doors get exactly what it is they're seeking in terms of an education. So I want to thank the Board of Trustees and certainly Chancellor Harris for giving me the grand opportunity to serve as the founding president for this institution. Thank you very much. There are a lot of snake stories, huh? Well, guess what? I got one too. That picture that Dave put up there with that yellow snake sign, that wasn't the original one. The original one was a little square sign that was on the gate, okay? And on July 1st, 1998, when I pulled through those gates, I said, why did Skip put that sign up there? And I immediately went into the portables, and I asked him, I said, did you put that sign up there for me? Because, you know, I don't like snakes. Can't stand them. Come to find out, you know, that with the wetlands, we were going to have lots of snakes around here. They had had many snakes. They had a snake book, a log book, where they would log the size of the snakes into the book, okay? It wasn't just a jar on Skip's desk. I have this vision in my head where after FL1 was first opened up, and several other people were in this room today, they called our office because they wanted us to call Mike the snake catcher. They were on top of the counters in the admissions office because the snake had found its way in, okay? Book bags on the floor, we used to have to go around, make sure instructors would let the students know, don't put your book bags on the portable floors, okay? You might go home one night and have a friend for life. This has been an incredible journey for Folsom Lake College. The very first semester that I was here, we didn't have enough rooms out in the community, but then we were able to convince a brand new elementary school to share some of its classes with us during the evening time. It was supposed to open up around the same time. But it had some issues, of course. And so one of the things that we ended up doing, we always would talk about making sure that we had first experiences. Every single thing that we were doing, we were recording them as a first experience for Folsom Lake College. That first semester for me was no exception. It was the original in and out, where students would be able to pull up at the elementary school because it wasn't finished. So we were standing in the middle of the street, checking people in, handing out the syllabus, begging them to come back. And they did. Every single one of those students came back the following week when the school was open. I was so pleased and proud that they accepted our message and our invitation. And so when I went over to check the classes, I opened up the very first door of a classroom. It was the most incredible picture. This guy's, one of the students' cheeks from the backside was hanging over a little 10-inch chair. We forgot that this was an elementary school. The classes that they offered us were for little people. So I went and started knocking on doors, and I'll never forget, Bill Kellogg, a minister at a church over on Scott and Natoma, offered up his portables. There were four of them, and we immediately, I don't know, you know, sometimes we did things so quickly, it got ahead of all of the approval pieces, but we got those four classrooms up and going the following week to make sure that we had, you know, big tables and big chairs for all of our adult students. It's been a pleasure to have a life pathway of working here at Folsom Lake College. I've had an issue with retirement, trying to figure out how to really define it, but I figured out when you have community college in your blood and in your heart, I don't care, you'll never retire. It's the most magnificent thing or experience of going through and making sure that the goals that you set, the vision that you have for an institution like this, and the students and the communities that it serves, it's all worth it. It was an incredible experience to be able to anchor this institution, not just here in Folsom, but also in Placerville, and most definitely down in Rancho Cordova. I like to ride public transportation, and any chance I can, when I go on light rail, I make sure I sit on the right side going down. I'm checking out the growth and development of the Rancho Cordova Center. When I come back up the hill, I'm on the left side so I can check out the growth and development of Folsom Lake College Center. We've had numerous opportunities going through design phases and all the master planning, all the conversations, all the shared governance committees, all the conversations that we had to design a fabulous institution for an incredible region. I want to thank Bob McGarvey. He's a city council member for here. There you are. Also another member of our foundation board, and he's on the city council for Rancho Cordova. They waited a long time for that center, and it's going to make a heck of a difference, a huge difference for the community of Rancho Cordova. So thank you, Bob, for hanging in there with Los Rios Community College District and Folsom Lake College to help make that happen. My proudest moments for Folsom Lake College are always 2 days in a year. I used to tell people all the time the best days are 2 days. The first day of school, when all the energy occurs with all of the students in the fall and the faculty and the staff. And then the second best day for me has always been graduation. The level of excitement in terms of accomplishments on both the part of the faculty and the students is just, it's just an enriching kind of experience that I always will carry deep in my heart about. Whenever I get out and about, students are asking me all the time, especially at restaurants, because I love asking the waiters, you know, where'd you go to school? Are you going to school? You know, it's like, my husband Frank always says, can't you stop? You know? The students always ask, when is Folsom Lake College going to become a four-year university? That's a compliment, a feather in all of your hats for all the great things that you're doing here. You heard one of the students talk about that in terms of his zero debt. That's fabulous, especially the way education and costs are going up today. But I've always said the hallmark of Folsom Lake College success is the success of its students. Wednesday night of this week, I turned on the television to listen to the Doug O.C. Ami Bira debate. I saw a familiar space, and I saw an incredible, bright, very articulate young lady by the name of Michaela, who is a student here, who was on the panel asking the questions. That was so, so good to see and hear. I want to thank all of you for everything that you do. I want to make sure I share that I'm watching firsthand all of the fabulous things that are going on here. I get updates from many, many people all across this region, and I am so proud to have been a part of this endeavor. Thank you.
Thank you, Thelma. So next, we're going to go back to Folsom Lake College's very earliest days, which what I've heard we could refer to as the original pioneer or cowboy of Folsom Lake College. Please welcome Dr. Skip Davies.
None of that's true. I want you to know you can't trust Bryce Harris. And you can't trust Thelma Scott Stillman to tell you the truth. Part of it's true. The part about the snakes is true. The part about asking permission, we didn't do that. Sometimes we did it a little bit later. Sometimes not at all. But that was okay in those days, because our job was to bring students here. Our job was to utilize all the facilities in the community and get the community to help us to get students here so that we could educate students and provide for students, and that eventually this college could be built. And so that was our job. But I want to talk about my first encounter with Thelma here. And then I got a story about Bryce as well. I was on my way up through the valley, and I had tried to recruit Thelma to come here. She was at the state chancellor's office in a nice air-conditioned building. And finally, she said she'd come. So that July day, she came, and it was hot, portable. So I showed her where her office was. She wasn't happy. And then that August, when she was down at that elementary school, and she was out there in the middle handing out these syllabuses, and she came back, and she gave me one of those treasured Thelma Scott Skillman looks. You didn't tell me I was gonna have to do that when I came here. I tried to mentor her, and I did a fair job, and I appreciate all you've done here, Thelma. You are a jewel, and we really, really, really appreciate all you've done. Do that. Secondly, I have a Bryce Harris story. That first day that he was touring the campus and he came to the portables, and we were talking about what the vision was. And he looked up on the hill and he saw that sign. And then he saw that snake in the jar. And he said, that's not a rattlesnake. We have big snakes in Oklahoma. That's just a baby snake, he told me. And we continued to do that. But later on that day, we showed him a real snake, so he was happy with that. I have a few remarks. You never know exactly what you're going to be asked to say. And I got to talk to Rachel about the lineup. You know, I should be first. The speech teacher should be last, Dr. Harris. And Thelma should have been in the middle. So next time. We'll do it differently. I'd like to take a moment to thank Thelma and Bryce for their leadership. This wouldn't be here without them. The Lowe's Community College District, its Board of Trustees, Carrie, and the City of Folsom, we could all tell stories about going to your council and asking for things that you weren't supposed to give us. And we can all thank the foundation, but it took that whole community to get this place started. And beginning in 1993, when Dave showed you that picture of that hill, there were horses out there some days. There was nothing. And you could get off the freeway and come down East Bidwell, and you'd be 5 minutes before you'd see a building. And then you couldn't see ours. But, you know, it's a masterpiece. You've done it, and you need to be proud of it. I'd like to take a minute or two to go back to some of the early visionaries and talk about those people who were visionaries and also those people who put the boots on the ground to make this happen. We have a tendency to kind of overlook some of them once in a while, and I don't want to do that. I want to mention Mark Hall. Mark Hall was in the district office. He was vice chancellor of finance, but he and Jack Kipp, very, very close. And they participated in the putting together of this piece of land that was donated, but I think the district had to pay $1,600 in taxes. That was a lot of money in those days, but Mark Hall was one of the initial planners for our district. I have Jack Kipp on my list as well, because Jack would invite me over to his house when I was here as a dean, and he'd give me advice. And I often listened to him to the same extent that I listened to Bryce Harris and Thelma. Another name we don't want that's true, Bryce. Another name we don't want to forget is Larry Dunn. Larry Dunn was the first coordinator that worked with the original man, Ken Snell and Dick and Dave, down in the DMV building. And he had no classrooms, and he started this college. Well, I want to talk about Louise DeVatz. Louise DeVatz was the right hand of Bryce Harris, who did the financing for this college. Pete Sorrell and Dave Clinchy, the people in the maintenance division that poured that concrete you saw the first day. And Kathleen Kirkland, who's sitting over there, we brought her up from Kathleen was at Cosumnes River College and had an opportunity to come up here and be our dean of administration, but we weren't a college yet, so the other boys wouldn't let her go to the meetings for the first two or three years, and she couldn't go. But when she did finally get allowed into the committee meeting with the AR in Sac City and CRC, we knew we had the right person because she has led the development of this college to where it is today. And the most outstanding thing about Kathleen is she survived myself and Thelma. And so, congratulations, Kathleen, for all of that. Most recently, the gentleman that came in behind Louise, John Sharp. John was a hire of Bryce Harris, who led this district in the development of all the facilities and all the colleges after the two bond issues. Outstanding. We need to look at him and thank him when you see him. One gentleman that we don't think of very much is Harry Elliott. Harry is part of the foundation, and Harry had a big part in this college being developed. We were building this number one building, and the fire marshal came in and shut it down. He said, it's gonna catch fire. I said, the damn thing's made of aluminum. How can it catch fire? And he shut it down. So Harry said, well, we'll fix that. Harry was building houses up on the hill. He was about a year away from putting a water tank in, and he moved that right up and put it in immediately, so we had fresh water down here. But it was that kind of community effort from Folsom that helped this college get going. Another story is a gentleman by the name of Dennis Rogers, whose wife works here. She's a biology teacher. And Dennis was the aide for Rod Pacheco in the assembly. And Folsom Lake College was on the list, but it wasn't going anywhere. And Dennis and his assemblyman, I don't know how they did this, but his assemblyman got appointed to the Assembly Ways and Means Committee for one day. Yeah. And Dennis did that. And we walked in there with our presentation, and we were sitting there next to the legislative analyst's office. And the legislative analyst's office started asking us the same question they'd asked us before and before again. And Mr. Pacheco said, excuse me, sir, I think that district's answered your questions. Is that not true? And the gentleman didn't even have a chance to say yes or no. And he said, I move the item. And they all voted yes, and we were a college. Well, that was part of it, because that was the assembly side, went to the Senate side, and they were waiting for us. It was terrible. But it got into conference committee, and with Bryce's leadership and patching up all that I'd screwed up down there, they got it approved. I want to say to Carrie about the city council. You've been SARS. The Chamber of Commerce with Joe was just super. And then I want to mention a gentleman who used to come by during the building of the college, and he'd advise me again. And he recently has passed away too. His name is Dave Cox. And he was one of our supervisors, and he was in the Senate. And he was important in getting money for this college. So in looking at all of you and looking at what we have here, you look and say, it's amazing, and it is. It is just truly amazing that in this short 20 years, that first picture of me, I had my hair dyed brown. It's always been gray like this. But, you know, it's amazing. And you talk about, you know, it takes a village to raise a child. It takes a community to build a college. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Skip. I learned a few new things. And I tell you what, when you come back for the college's 50th anniversary celebration, you can go first. All right. So now we'd like to acknowledge the founders of this wonderful, wonderful college. There was a group of faculty members, classified staff, and managers who put their hearts and souls into building this fantastic institution. These are individuals, hopefully they're wearing their buttons. If you haven't, there are more out in the lobby. But they are folks who, as we say here at Folsom Lake College, wear many hats, because they were asked to do whatever needed to be done. You heard that from Dave Hill. And that's why our college is a reality today. So our gratitude and heartfelt appreciation goes out to all of you. And when you greet these folks in the lobby, there's a reception that follows this. Please ask them how many different jobs they've had at Folsom Lake College. I would guess you might get a surprising answer. And so to the founders, you set the foundation. And I mean that figuratively and literally for this beautiful college today. And not only have you helped us serve the 68,000 students who have passed through these doors in the last 10 years, you are the foundation for serving the hundreds of thousands of students we have yet to serve. And I want you to enjoy that and think about that, and think about the number of students that this college will have served when the college opens the time capsule. You'll be able to see it out in the lobby at the college's 100th anniversary celebration in 2104. You have each and every one contributed to those students over the next 90 years. So with that, I want you to sit back and enjoy a photo montage of Folsom Lake College founders.
When they pull, tell me, can you hold on? When they say you should change, can you lift your head high and stay strong? Will you give up, give in when your heart's crying out that it's wrong? Will you love you for you at the end of it all? Acceptance and approval. We keep forgetting that's the one thing we should know. reflection, the foreigner after all these years. However, life she was trying to be something besides herself. Now time has passed and she's ended up someone else with regret. What is it in us that makes us feel the need to keep pretending? Gotta let
if we could, please, will all the founders please stand up? We'd like to give you all a huge round of applause. So we do. Your commitment and dedication to the students of this college will make a difference and has made a difference to the students we've served, those students yet to come, for our communities, for generations and generations. So thank you for your service to our students and thank you for your commitment to Folsom Lake College. So as we begin to close our program, we're not closed yet, I do want to make a couple of acknowledgments. Again, I'd like to thank our Afro-Cuban funk band and urban jazz project under the direction of Professor Philip Ango. Please give them a round of applause. And I do note, too, that is also a student club. So those students are quite talented, and it's just delightful to hear them. And then another round of applause, please, for Mosaic Dance Company under Professor Debbie Werk. And last and certainly not least, and the reason we are all here, thank you to all of the founders. So, yeah, give them a round of applause. So after our final presentation, you are all invited to a reception in the lobby, and out there you will find several exciting things for you to view. We have a faculty art show, a student art show. We have a student, Jonathan Spillman, who's going to be playing the piano for us. The art gallery will be open as well. So, and also as Kim noted, there are two soccer games this afternoon, men's and women's, so show your falcontude, as we say, and go out and take a visit to the new soccer fields. And sorry, I've got the student's name wrong. Jonathan Shapiro will be playing for us. So, also tomorrow, if you don't know, we're doing a big open house for the community from 11 to 3 here at the Folsom main campus. And it's a wonderful opportunity, and we're going to showcase our programs and services up here, celebrate our history, share our vision of this beautiful college with our community. And so, a recent interviewee once shared with me that he, when he did all the research for Folsom Lake College and was preparing for the interview, that he said, you know, Folsom Lake College is on the precipice of greatness. And I said, I could not agree more. All right? So with that, please sit back and get ready to welcome the newest member of the Folsom Lake College family.